In this video, I'm going to be unboxing this Craftsman CMCG400M1 4.5 inch grinder kit. So this is a product that just came out by Craftsman. They're now part of Black & Decker, Stanley, DeWalt, which is all one company. This is made with mixed materials from overseas as well as in the United States. It's, I believe, they're made actually in, assembled in the United States. It comes with a 4.0 amp hour battery pack that's lithium ion. Again, these came out in 2018, and I just picked this up for $79 at Lowe's. It comes with a 20 volt lithium ion battery. It's 4.5 inch discs that it takes. It can run at 9,000 RPMs, and again, the battery is a 4 amp per hour battery. That's a pretty good battery. I mean, that's going to be strong and powerful. And again, it comes with a 3-year warranty. So we're gonna start by unboxing it. And the other thing about it is that the handle can be put on both sides. That's pretty cool. So I strongly was attracted to the Craftsman tool set because they're so brand new. And I think they're pricing them at such a low price to gain market share. And I studied microeconomics in college. I didn't really learn much, but I did learn something about market share, and that is when a new product is being introduced. Sometimes when a new product is being introduced, if you lower the price, you can get more customers to start buying it and beat out the competition. Although, it's funny because Stanley, Black & Decker, DeWalt, Craftsman have almost a monopoly on tools. It's a great way to reintroduce the popular Craftsman brand to the world. People will swear by this brand. I've had always good success with Craftsman. In fact, they can't think of a single Craftsman tool I've ever bought that I've ever broke. But that's just me. So here's it comes with a 4.5 inch Craftsman metal grinding disc. Again, this isn't necessarily the best. Some of those diamond blade grinder kits are probably better, but at least they give you a grinder kit. I mean, that's about what, up to $5-$10. Going to run and show you a metal grinder kit, but we'll get to that in a second. So, diamond blade grinding disc. Okay, so we're removing this plastic. I mean, the world's kind of complaining about plastic problems. Do they need to really put these in plastics? They don't. They really don't. I mean, Craftsman, these are wonderful tools. So here it is. It's got the guard. I believe you can move the guard. Yeah. So you can rotate the guard easily all the way around. Or take it off. I'm going to be doing some cutting, so I want to have my guard down this way. I'm going to do some tile cutting. Ooh, that's hard. Okay, so, and you got a trigger here. A lock switch here, and your battery goes there. So that's the first element. Then our battery, or our handle is in here. So it comes with a wrench. There's a wrench there. There's the handle, and you can put the handle on either side. So then, again, $79 for a lithium ion powered grinding kit. that includes a 4 amp hour lithium ion battery. This is a massive battery, $99 at Lowe's. So this kit was $79, and that's $99. So do the math, and we get that they're basically giving you a free $99 battery, and so you're getting everything for negative $20. So you're earning money by buying this. I think if that's correct based on the math. You earn money by buying Craftsman. If talk about market share strategies, I don't think that's just brilliant. I think it's brilliant. I think these Craftsman tools for homeowners and stuff for just general use are great. This is the charger. And there's even more in here. So we keep on going with the box. These are the instruction manuals. Always RTFM. I don't care how good you are with anything. Like, I used to not ever read manuals, but sometimes you'll pick up on small things that the engineers want you to know. There's nothing else in the box, but there it is. I keep my boxes because I like to put away my tools in my boxes. Because I'm not always using the tools, just when I need to. So I always try to save all the materials instead of throwing in the garbage. And I pay attention to the way they pack so I can repack it. So that's kind of sort of how it went back. Okay, so that was the box. Save your boxes. When you move, you might need them. And plus, if you need to ever resell it because you get a new tool, you always have this. Or even more, when the tool goes bad, you can take it to the store in a nice box and not look like, you know, some person that just came up the street with a tool. There's more credibility when you come into the store with a box of your tool. Then you'll be able to get more service from the, probably from Lowe's or anybody else. Okay, so here's the manual. Always RTFM. This is the CMCG400 Craftsman angle grinder. First page is with very most important thing is the certification that they had to add. Okay, there's the diagrams, and then they get into safety, electrical safety. I would always look at how they recommend using the battery, so recharging it, using it, how not to overheat it, basically how to take care of it. Do not use a battery pack or tool that is damaged or modified. Don't expose the battery pack or tool to fire or excessive temperatures, obviously. Follow all charging instructions. And then you can service them. And then they mentioned some safety warnings for grinding, sanding, wire brushing. It can also, there's a kickback thing that this could do, so that's pretty important for angle grinding. You can get a kickback, so I would highly recommend the RTFM. So you get the maximum life. Here's the charging instructions and some important charging notes. Longest life and best performance can be obtained if the battery is charged when the air temperature is between 65 and 75 degrees outside. Fahrenheit. 65 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Do not charge the battery when it's very hot, like 40 degrees. Oh, below 40 degrees, or above 104. Yeah, very hot. The charger and the battery pack may become warm to touch while charging. This is normal condition, and it's not indicate a problem. Facilitate the cooling. Avoid placing the charger battery pack in the warm environment, such as a metal sheet or an insulated trailer. Check the operation receptacle of plugging in a lamp or other appliance if the battery pack does not charge properly. One of the tricks to these, if these batteries start to not work, is you can get a voltage, variable voltage current power supply and charge it up. They have a current limiting system in their smart charging system. This isn't just lithium-ion batteries, there's also some circuitry in them. Anyways, let's go back and look at the battery. This case is easy to break. But otherwise, it's solid. I would just be careful. Okay, and then make sure that your receptacle is connected. More about battery pack should be recharged when it also fails to produce sufficient power on jobs which were easily done previously. Do not continue to use under these conditions. Foreign materials of a conductive nature such as, but not limited to grinding dust, metal chips, steel wood, aluminum foil, or metallic particles should be kept away from the charger cavities. Always unplug the charger from the power supply when there is no battery pack in the cavity. Unplug the charger before attempting to clean. Do not freeze or immerse the charger in water or any other liquid. Okay. So they go through the charging instructions. And the instructions on how to install it, how to put the discs on, and basically how to operate it. So, what the angle, there's the angle you want to use for angle grinding. A lot of people don't read these instructions, but you can pick up a lot of good tools. There's tells you about brushes and wheels. There's a lot of information. Then different types of accessories that are available. Such as this, so the disc, another type of disc, a wire brush, a wire wheel, sanding flap discs. So you can use this for all sorts of different things. And then we get into the French. Alrighty, and there's the other languages. So lithium charges already comes with your grinder. There's a meter here, so you press that button. So it's on the first setting. Pretty low. Let's see what it does. Okay, let's see. Make sure that nothing's loose here. Where's our... There should be a bolt here or something. It's probably in the box. Okay. So press that and be careful. Okay, so I've never operated this and I didn't really read the instructions. But let's see, I plugged it in. Okay, oh, now it's there. It's on lock. Maybe there's a reason why it's on lock. So again, go back to reading the instructions. RTFM. Anyways, so let's look for the tool. We need the tool. It should be a bolt. I don't see a bolt. Again, I'm new to angle grinders, so I used one when I was a kid, probably like 10, but it's been a long time. So there's nothing else in the box. So, okay, that makes sense. So in the old days they used to use a bolt. They used to put on the angle grinder and then tighten it, but now they've got this fancy key. And the wrench is here. So you're going to use that wrench to tighten this up. This is something new in the past 30 years or 40 years or so, I don't know. I used to just use a bolt and tighten the wrench. Okay. So we're going to charge this and we're going to use it to cut some holes in tile. And before I go, I just want to show you the wonderful new disc I'm on. This up. It's a rigid diamond blade, 4.5 inch disc. It has this wonderful pattern for the diamond coating, and they say it keeps the rigid blade cool. It's new on the market as of January 2019. Could have been out earlier, but I haven't seen any reviews for this. There's a lot of comment reviews, but I haven't seen any videos for this, so we're going to do a video for this and see how it works to cut tile. All right, we'll be back.